young men who talk the most, who talk the longest. What I heard him say, I don't think the sky is the limit for you. The sky is not even the limit. The sky is the beginning. And we believe that as Young Gamez Entertainment, you are going to go places, you are going places, and we from tourism, we are from tourism, and as you know, there's some people who don't talk well on what we do in tourism. Look, there's no way you can stop us from entertaining our people. All the governments in this world have come up with new cabinet portfolios for ministers responsible for happiness and entertainment. Who knows that in Dubai, there's a minister responsible for happiness and entertainment, and which is what we are showing them. Yes, we are told that if you bring people from other countries to come and entertain us, they must entertain us in our own way. No, you don't bring someone from a foreign land to come and imitate you. No, we don't do that. We bring them to come and show us what they do. Entertainment is now the biggest thing that any government that wish to remain in power should aim at. Governments that wish to remain in power must have ways of entertaining their people. Zimbabwe's people need happiness. And what I've seen here is just a complement, or is just complementing what we in tourism are doing. So we feel obliged, very much so, very much obliged to support this group, this enterprising youthful group, the Young Gamez Entertainment. We feel obliged. We feel duty bound. You have given us a duty to support you. We don't want to support you only morally by saying, coming here and saying certain things, like what I'm saying in front of you. We must support you in real terms. So what I'm saying, for you, the Young Gamez Entertainment, I'm inviting you to my office on Monday, so that we can discuss how best we can support you. As the Zimbabwe Tourism Authority, we are duty bound. We feel obliged to support you. And I'm simply saying that what I've heard here, what I've seen here, I think you guys, you've got a vision. What I'm saying, I want to support you by really, really shaping more sharply your vision. I'm not saying it's not sharp. It is sharp. But I just want to, when I listened to it, when it was being said by Trinity, I think there's room for us to really make it more solid, isn't it? So that we can really do something that we can achieve. And after, you are saying, he said by 2030, we want to see something being achieved by 2020. We want to see something being achieved by 2025. So that when we come to 2030, we have conquered Africa, like what you were saying. And I'm simply saying that we want to meet on Monday in my office at 10 o'clock and let's discuss more about your vision, which I like. I like young people with a vision. I don't like young people who dream and end up having nightmares. Because once you dream, you end up having nightmares. So I want you to have vision. And I don't remember the young man who spoke last before Trinity. he was giving excuses for talking too much. No, you don't have to. You don't have to. We were prepared to listen for you for the whole night. The late master of ceremony did wrong to interject you. He should have allowed you. We have come to listen to you, and we wanted to listen to you the whole night. But what happened, of course, that's what masters of ceremony do. When you give them the authority, the right to say time up, like she was saying. But when you come to my office, of course, yes, you have me for 1 hour, so come prepared to discuss with me for 1 hour.
And other stories, visit our website, www.263chat.com. Follow us on Twitter, @263chat, and like our Facebook page, 263chat.